Hey legends, it's time to take the idea seriously that we live in a simulation. I've spent 2 hours researching videos on the internet, so I'm qualified to tell a mass audience that yes, we do live in a computer program. Humans themselves are often the first dead giveaway that reality is bullshit. Look at her, she's broken. Her coding was clearly done by an intern at Westworld. Cats are the second dead giveaway that life is pretty fishy. This one is like, oopsie daisy, fuck, act normal, look normal, I'm just a cat. As soon as you turn your back on them, bam, you'll notice their core programming is riddled with glitches. Doppelgangers is just some lazy bastard clicking create duplicate. We've all got them. My doppelganger is this dog. It freaks me the fuck out. Clock radios. There's a reason we're not allowed those anymore. Whoever invented everything knew they were a liability. You look at a clock radio long enough, you'll see the truth. Oh, you'll see the truth. And what about the metaverse? Remember that? Yeah, enough said. Oh, watch this. Sure, it looks like a television interview like any other television interview, but tell me how that just happened. Were you paying attention or were you too busy looking at the woman in the red dress? Scarlet, how does an entire person behind her vanish? I call it the ScarJo theory. If you get too close to her gravitational force, you'll be automatically deleted. How about science teachers? They're trapped and they know it. Their free speech has limitations and parameters on it, so they come up with these quirky demonstrations to warn us about existence. I see you, science teachers. I see you, and thank you. Thanks to Aussie Man fan also, Trevor, who sent this in. As we can see, he found a glitch on his farm down south. I don't know if he should pop that. We're not ready to see what's on the other side of Australia, are we? If you tear back that fabric of the cosmos? No, I don't think so. The surface is terrifying enough. Let's get back to people being the biggest giveaway that we're in a quantum computer simulation. Our ability to meander in the wrong direction and follow each other in said wrong direction is second to none. Look at the way Beanie Guy stops and turns around. That is unnatural as fuck, isn't it? He's glitching out. Big time. We can't cope when our environment changes unless we're given a software update. The operating system we live in must stay familiar to us, but never too familiar or samey-same, or that can also become a glitch. The way these cars have been planted on this street is another sign of virtual engineering laziness. The automotive department must have had a budget cut. It can only render white utes or pickup trucks, whatever you're programmed to call them. Anyway, I rest my case. Oh, also, ChatGPT. My mum is like, the fuck is that all about? I'm inclined to listen to mum on this occasion.
Hey legends, if you are confident enough to wear the Aussie Man doppelganger t-shirt, it is for sale now at aussiemanshop.com. The link is below in the post description or the comments. Look out for the door, Emma. You can go and I'll keep walking this way. Go check it out. Go check it. The Aussie, now I'll walk backwards and we've switched. Yep, nah, I like wearing it. I'm weird and confident enough to go around wearing it myself. Anyway, let's not make this long.
Also, fuck it, I'm going to call it a limited run for 30 days only, and we're going to be charitable. $2 from every sale will go to the Lost Dogs Home in Melbourne. They've been around since 1910, so I trust the fucking work they're doing. $2 from every sale, Lost Dogs Home, go buy it now.